The next speaker I'd like to invite is Borys Wrzesnewskyj, who was the Liberal Member of Parliament for the Toronto Federal Riding of Etobicoke Centre from 2004 to 2011. Mrs. Wrzesnewskyj had served in a number of positions, including Official Opposition Critic for Citizenship, Immigration, and Multiculturalism, and Special Advisor to the Liberal Leader on Emerging Democracies. Since his student days at the University of Toronto, Mr. Wrzesnewskyj has continually built on his international human rights and pro-democracy work, including efforts in Europe, the former Communist bloc, the former Soviet Union, Africa, and the Middle East. Mr. Wrzesnewskyj, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, we live in the best country on the planet, in Canada. And we're unique amongst all of the nations of the world. You see, we've come together from all parts of the planet. We're of every race, every religion, every ethnicity, every culture. And as individuals, we've arrived here in Canada and built something so much greater than the sum of our individual parts. My parents and grandparents were political refugees to Canada. I'm the son and grandson of political refugees. And Canada was freedom's shores. Canada is a place where we respect each other. Canada is a place where we not only respect all our various racial, religious, ethnic, cultural differences, we celebrate those differences. When my grandparents and parents arrived here, they landed on what they called Freedom's Shores. And they called Canada Freedom Shores because this is the place where they were free from the oppression of a totalitarian regime and where they were free from the victimization based on ethnicity. Those were the horrors and the terrors that they escaped to come here to Canada. Now, some would say that in this particular case, freedom of speech, that freedom trumps the odious nature of hate propaganda. Well, you know, we have many freedoms. Freedom to carry a gun doesn't allow one to point that gun at other individuals. And freedom of speech should not allow someone to target individual communities for hatred. Our very freedom as citizens has been diminished. When a person, because their community has been ethnically targeted on public airwaves, no longer feel secure because they are members of that community. For many, it's almost like pinning a target to their chest. And part of that promise of Canada, of our freedom, has been taken away from them. Now, as was mentioned, 6 months after this hateful rant against the Roma community, Mr. Levant finally apologized. Now, the skeptics amongst us would say, well, he realized that he potentially faced criminal charges for his hate propaganda.
That's true.
And some would say, well, now that he's apologized, that's good enough.
No.
Well, friends, when a police officer catches a thief, And the thief says, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean it. I'm so sorry." Does that mean that that thief is no longer charged?
No!
No!
The penalty may be mitigated, but that individual will be charged. Now, here's the difference. When property is stolen, it can be returned. But what Mr. Levant stole from the Roma Canadian community cannot be addressed, cannot be returned, unless the issue itself is addressed through the courts.
Yes!
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 Friends, as I said, we live in the best country on the planet. We live in incredible freedom. And what we've done here is a shining beacon to the rest of the planet. But once in a while, there are shadows cast on that light by individuals that hide amongst us, like the Zundels, or even those who would propagate that same sort of hatred on public airwaves, like Mr. Levant. We must have the fortitude to stand up to that sort of hatred.
Yes!
And we must do it.
Yes! Yes!
Precisely because we live in the best country on the planet. We live in respect of each other.
Yeah.
And we will celebrate all our multicultural diversity. And we'll do so because we're Canadian. Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Borys.